saw many people fleeing the volcano, and many didn't have cars. By this time, the plume had risen to 15 kilometers high, and unfortunately, not everyone got out.
Most of the trench has gone, and about the lower half of Harris's, there are many buildings on fire.
Roger, Paul. Thanks for that. I'll relay that to Angus if he has
In fact, 25 people perished that day. That was in 1997 on the island of Montserrat. And in many ways, that eruption wasn't very different from what happened here at Sunset Crater 900 years ago. There were people living in this area who were farming, and they had to flee the area to avoid the effects of the eruption and ended up building the structures in the Wupatki area. I witnessed firsthand how dangerous and lethal these types of Plinian eruptions can be. And that's why I wanted to understand why the Sunset Crater eruption was so violent. Sunset Crater is the youngest basaltic cinder cone in the San Francisco volcanic field. It's located close to population centers of Phoenix and Flagstaff, Arizona. The plumbing system underneath the volcanoes is complex. It connects all the 600 volcanoes that make up the field. This makes it difficult to predict when or even where the next cinder cone will erupt. We know from geological and archaeological digs near the Wupatki ruins that the Sunset Crater eruption was extremely explosive and violent compared to other basaltic cinder cones. And we want to know why. The first thing we wanted to know when we started our research at Sunset Crater was exactly how high in the atmosphere the eruption plume rose. To do that, we can use the footprint of the ash and the scoria fall around the volcano to back calculate that height.